Arabic and English book reseller based here in Jordan. Ala'a, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Great. So tell me about Jamalon. How did you get inspired to start the platform?
Well, it's a long story, my story with books. I love books since I was at school, and I used to love the traditional commerce. I was helping my family with several projects all over the years. So, and I did my master's degree in IT. Combining all these elements were taking me to starting Jamalon, an online bookstore for books, where I have my passion for books and for commerce, which is now I'm working with e-commerce, and with IT, which is the back end of Jamalon.
How did you decide to start your own company?
It's like, it was long before I go to do my master's degree. I was dreaming about having my own company, expanding in the region, doing the next.com. It was difficult to quit my daily job and start a startup and taking the risk. But finally, I took it, and it's always, I say, it's a combination between fear and joy. The joy that I'm having my own company and I'm taking it to the next level, hopefully. And the fear that there are a lot of obstacles and I have to do and to solve all of these problems in order to stay in business and to expand this company.
Was your family supportive? How did they get involved?
Well, since day one, actually. When I remember when I quit my my job, I started at home. So my resources were completely my brothers and sisters. I have four brothers and two sisters and my mom, who were working with me at Jamalon. We were splitting the tasks and doing everything from home.
Market, who do you predominantly sell to in the Arab world and outside?
Well, we target Arabs all over the world. We focus on the MENA region because there is lack of books availability in the region. It's difficult to move books all over the Arab world. So people usually wait for book fairs in order to buy books. Now they have Jamalon, which is a 24/7 online book fair for Arabs.
I see. How do you compete with services like people ordering from Amazon or something through Arabics?
Well, first of all, we differentiate Jamalon by having Arabic books, which is something that Amazon till now does not support Arabic. So they do not have the Arabic interface, they do not carry Arabic books. While we have more than 120,000 Arabic books and 250,000 English books. This is number one. Another thing is that we support cash on delivery, which is a service through Aramex. We try to compete also with the shipping prices and shipping costs. So it takes us a lot of time negotiating prices with the freight forwarders and with booksellers from UK and from the US in order to get good deals where we can compete with Amazon with book prices, even with the English industry.
Your logistics, do you use
Aramex?
How do you handle the logistics?
Well, we depend on Aramex, especially with our expansion. So wherever there is Aramex hub, we are sure that we can handle the logistics with high quality support and high quality service. That's how we are expanding right now in Saudi Arabia and in Lebanon.
How quickly can you get someone a book?
If it is an Arabic book, it's like right now in Jordan, we ship the next day through Aramex. And if it's from Lebanon, we ship for free from Lebanon to anywhere in Jordan, for example. But we combine our shipments per week, so it takes 4 to 7 days. If it's an English book, right now it takes 2 weeks, but we are working with Aramex to get a good time with good rates for our customers.
Are these the top three countries that your customers come from, Saudi, Lebanon, and Jordan?
Well, actually, Lebanon is a source for books for us, but it's not a market for our books because it's a fact that Lebanon is one of the biggest countries for publishers, but their publishers do not sell their books inside. Most of their sales are outside. Lebanese prefer to read sometimes in French or English, much more than what they read in Arabic. So Lebanon is a source of books for us. Our market is in the Levant, especially in the Gulf region, Saudi Arabia, Jordan, and Arabs outside the region, in the US and in Europe.
Do you sell in Egypt? Do you compete with places like books.eg.com.eg?
Well, till now we did not tap into the Egyptian market. According to our plan, we are expanding in Saudi Arabia and Lebanon. Then our expansion will go to Egypt and UAE. So Egypt also for us is a source of books. We look at Egypt as a source for books, not as a market in the beginning to sell our books. But it's come by the end, by the way.
I see. How do you differentiate yourself from competitors?
Well, we try to get always the best deals, the best prices for books for our customers. We target the mass market, so we offer completely cheap prices for books. We maintain very low margin just to offer books for the cheapest price anywhere, anytime. And we try to do something different for the industry by supporting the publishing industry. So we launched recently Sophia Translation to support translation from other languages into Arabic. So we'll have a new content, we'll get people encouraged to write new books for the region.
I see. How do you divide the revenue between the publisher and Jamalon, the reseller?
Well, usually we get around 50% of list price from publishers. So we keep around 5% for Jamalon and we give the rest for our customers.
I see. And are you profitable yet?
Actually, not yet, because our target is to have much more market share from the market and to expand our services, and we look at books as a loss leader in this region.
How has your experience been at Oasis 500? You first joined a year ago?
Right, it was last July. So it's a good incubator in this region. They helped us a lot in expanding and accelerating our business model in 100 days. So they give you 3 months of incubation, and in these 3 months you have to tune your business model in order to pitch and present your startup in front of angel investors. That's what we did last October.
And it helped?
Yeah, it was completely helpful. We successfully raised $400,000 for Jamalon.
Fantastic. Mabruk.
Allah barik fi.
I believe we announced that. What are your biggest challenges as an e-commerce company? What do you hope to see improve in the sector? And what would your advice to a young entrepreneur be?
Well, for my industry, the biggest challenge is, the good thing is that we have good logistics because of the existence of Aramex. The market that's not, that's still young is the payment sector. We face problems with the payment methods in the region. And for the publishing industry especially, we are facing problems with the censorship. So we have to deal with censorship and laws in Jordan, another censorship law in Saudi Arabia, another censorship law. In each Arab country, we have to deal with the local authorities for the books that are banned in their countries. This is a big headache for us. Well, right now at Jamalon we depend on PayPal and cash on delivery, where through PayPal we process the credit cards, and it counts for around 10% of our sales, where 90% goes for cash on delivery.
Wow. That's in Saudi and Lebanon as well?
Right now we have cash on delivery in Saudi and in Jordan. We'll open cash on delivery in the rest of countries, but for each time, we have to have our own hub in each country to offer cash on delivery and to combine the books, Arabic and English books, for our customers.
I see. And finally, what would you advise someone looking to start up an e-commerce company in Jordan?
In Jordan? Jordan is a good market to tune your business model and to learn a lot from your industry, to get good relations and good connections. But as you said, it's an e-commerce, so Jordan will be the start, and then you have to move all over the region, where the people have good purchase power and where people are spending money on e-commerce strongly, especially as we see right now with our expansion. Saudi Arabia is a big market, the Gulf is a hot market. So Jordan is still the beginning where we started, and our headquarters are here, but we are moving all over the region where there is a big purchase power and a lot of opportunities in e-commerce.
Keep us posted on your progress.
Sure.
Thanks for chatting with us.
Thank you.